everyone, my name is Sishtha Mishra, a legal intern in LexClick and Company. So, today in this video, I will talk about duties of an advocate to a client. Before just starting with my video, I would like to tell that this video does not solicit any kind of promotion or advertisement under the guideline of Bar Council of India. The sole purpose of this video is only for education purpose. Now, let's get started with the video. So, duties of an advocate toward client. It is very important for every advocate to know their duty and also follow their duties. So, it is the duty of an advocate to fearlessly uphold the interests of the client and also give him justice. Establish a good relationship with the client with an object the client can easily share any matter with an advocate. So, we can say that the relationship between an advocate and a client is highly fiduciary. Now, duties of an advocate is listed down in professional ethics from rule 11 to rule 33. Now moving ahead, what are the duties of an advocate to a client? That is duty number one. An advocate should accept any brief in the court or before any authority and also the nature of the case. So this means that before just jumping into the case, before just analyzing the case, before just starting with the case, it is very important for every advocate to know in brief about the case, brief about the fact of this case and also the nature of the case. Moving ahead, that is duty number two. An advocate shall not ordinarily withdraw from engagement when accepted without sufficient cause and unless reasonable and sufficient notice given to the client upon his withdrawal from a case, he shall refund such part of the fee. So, it is duty of an advocate that he cannot withdraw in between from the case. He cannot leave his case in between and in case unless any reasonable and sufficient cause happen, then only he may live this case in between by giving prior notice to his client upon his withdrawal from a case and he shall refund such part of the fee. Moving ahead, that is duty number three. An advocate should fearlessly uphold the interests of the client by all fair and honorable means. Moving ahead, that is duty number four. An advocate shall fair and reasonably submit on the behalf of the case. This means that he should be fair enough and reasonable and submit everything on the behalf of the client, not anyone else. Therefore, it is very important for every advocate to treat nicely to his client and also advocate should try their best to get justice to their client and also advise their client with proper guideline and in a proper manner. Moving ahead, that is duty number five. An advocate should not act on the instruction of any other person and his client or his authority agent. This means that he should not disclose, he should not consider any other instructions of the third party, any other किसी दूसरे का client और agent, authority agent के बाद अगर वो किसी और की instruction को नहीं सुनना चाहिए, he only listen to his client and his authority agent to make his case privacy. Now moving ahead, that is duty number six. An advocate shall and not any time is a party to fomenting of litigation. This means before I tell what this line mean, I would like to tell that fomenting means bhadkana. कोई भी भड़काना किसी भी क्लाइंट को भड़काने से पहले इट इज़ नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ द ड्यूटी ऑफ ए क्लाइंट कि वो अपने ड्यूटी नहीं है किसी भी एडवोकेट की कि वो अपने क्लाइंट को भड़काए कि शुड सॉल्व हिज केस पीसफुली एंड विदाउट एनी फॉर्मेंटिंग ऑफ लिटिगेशन. नाउ मूविंग अहेड that is point number seven, that is duty number seven. An advocate shall not directly or indirectly commit a breach of the obligation imposed by section 126 of Evidence Act. Now, what is section 126 of Evidence Act? Section 126 of Evidence Act talks about privileged communication. This means that when it's advocate duty that he should not disclose any matter, any secrets about the case to the third party. But in some case, in big cases like fraud, yeah, illegal means, yeah, koi bhi criminal background, in these cases, he may disclose the matter just for guideline. moving ahead, that is point number 8, an advocate should keep account of the client money entrusted to him. This means that it is very important for every advocate to keep the records of his account, of his fee, so that आगे चल के उनको कोई दिक्कत ना हो, दे बोथ द एडवोकेट एज वेल एज क्लाइंट. मूविंग अहेड, दैट इज पॉइंट नंबर 9, मीन्स ड्यूटी नंबर 9, एंड एडवोकेट शुड नॉट डिस्क्लोज कम्युनिकेशन मेड टू देम इन कोर्स ऑफ प्रोफेशनल एंगेजमेंट इवन आफ्टर द केस इज ओवर. ही शुड मेंटेन अ गुड कम्युनिकेशन विद द क्लाइंट इवन आफ्टर द केस इज गेट्स ओवर. दिस मीन्स दैट केस खत्म होने के बाद भी उसका गुड कम्युनिकेशन होना चाहिए अपने क्लाइंट के साथ. ही शुड मेड अ प्रोफेशनल एंगेजमेंट बिटवीन दैम, प्लस कोई भी ही शुड नॉट डिस्क्लोज एनी फैक्ट्स टू हिज थर्ड टू द थर्ड पार्टी. मूविंग अहेड, ड्यूटी नंबर 10, इट इज़ द ड्यूटी ऑफ एन एडवोकेट दैट द मनी ऑफ द कोर्ट गिवन इन द नेम ऑफ द क्लाइंट मस्ट बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द क्लाइंट एंड अंडर नो कंडीशन शुड बी केप्ट बाय द एडवोकेट. इट इज़ रिटन इन वेरी सिंपल लैंग्वेज दैट कोई भी मनी कोर्ट जब क्लाइंट के नेम पे देता है, इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एन एडवोकेट टू गिव मनी टू द क्लाइंट, नॉट केप्ट बाय द एडवोकेट. ओके, एंड आई वुड लाइक टू टेल वन केस इन दिस, दैट इज हरीश चंद्र तिवारी वर्सेस बीजू. इन दिस केस सुप्रीम कोर्ट डिसाइडेड दैट द एडवोकेट डिड नॉट पेड द अमाउंट ऑफ द क्लाइंट विच वॉज टेकन फ्रॉम कोर्ट एंड thus the same of the advocate was removed from the role of the advocate. So now these are the some duties which I read today, that is about duties of an advocate to a client, and it is very important for every advocate who are going to be advocate or who are practicing as an advocate should know their duties and should know their rules and must be followed by them fearlessly and reasonably. Therefore, these duties of an advocate towards his client is practiced by an advocate to protect the rights of the client. And also, there are many client legal rights using client can be justice from court against the unjust done by the advocates. Now, thank you for watching this video. Hope you like it. Please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And also, for any query, please, and for any query or any feedback, let me know in the comment box now. Till then, take care. Goodbye.